Alive Inside, The Story of Music and Memory, was produced and first released in 2014 and was met with a resounding response and was in fact the Audience Award winner at the 2014 Sundance Film Festival.
And the focus and the clarity, the pure joy and love that he received from that, I can't even begin to explain how it calmed and brought so much of him back home. He would be dancing and singing, "When the moon hits your eye like the big pizza pie," and classical music, and everything in between, folk and rock and all. Thank you from all of my heart. And how can we best contribute to make sure that other people have this incredible resource?
We depend on the public's generosity. So it's really as simple as that and as difficult as that. So that's our goal, is to bring this to every person who might benefit. So it's kind of a tall order in every kind of healthcare setting, regardless of age, and not even all, just folks with some form of dementia. And thank you for sharing your story and how it worked at home. But also for people who have psychiatric diagnoses, like Denise, people in pain, people with intellectual and developmental disabilities. It's then the intergenerational component, layering that in. In Wisconsin and Texas, we have full-time music and memory staff, getting large-scale student involvement, college chapters of music and memory, high school chapters of music and memory, building it into nursing training curriculum, our rehab curriculum, and we want it to be in all of the hospitals. So all of the hospitals in Colorado, based on what we've learned, running in the largest public hospital systems in both the U.S. and Australia, that this is, it works just as well in a number of different departments. So it works with, yes, reducing delirium and for elders, but it's being used in inpatient psych, it's being used in rehab medicine, it's being used in OBGYN, in drug recovery. So there's just kind of this unexpected source of riches in terms of impact.
I'll try to be humble about it. It's difficult to be humble when these most amazing studies are happening around us. I do want to address one of the prior comments that was made. Thank you for your story. There isn't a day that goes by, and we can all share this with you, that someone doesn't call us on the phone or text us or email us and say, "Thank you. Thank you for bringing my life back. Thank you for giving me my mom back again." And I thought to myself, if there's any way, what a great gift this would be to give families where they can have their loved one with them again. I just want to share that. But the studies. So we have some phenomenal studies. University of Utah, I can't say enough about that. University of Utah came out with this phenomenal study where they actually scanned brains and they actually did a map of the brain. And they went to functional MRIs, if you're familiar with what that is, and they noted the biochemistry in the brain and how the neurons were connecting with each other. And their story behind it is even just more phenomenal. But this was a person that went to them and said, "Show me, prove to me how and why this works with my wife." And that's how they got the funding for their study. How phenomenal is that? And so they actually did a beautiful job of proving it. It's on our website under current research. So you'll see it if you go to current research on our website. And so you'll see the brain and how it's ignited in the areas of functioning that are specific to the problems we see with individuals with Alzheimer's. You know, that agitation, that inability to process movements. And so they were able to show that with personalized music, not just genre music, that the brain itself is showing new reconnectivity areas around damaged areas. And, you know, great example I saw today, one of our music therapists, a really great colleague of ours, did a presentation where, I love that example, it was just wonderful. But, you know, you're driving in a car and you're going someplace, and all of a sudden, the road's blocked and you can't get to where you have to go. And sort of like that's what happens in the brain with dementia. And so what happens is, in the world of personalized music, well, you know what? I'm going to back up and I'm going to go around this damaged problem here to get to where I have to go. But the bottom line is you eventually get to where you have to go. You just went a different way. So the music and memory program is a key to get you there.
In California, we had a large project that's just tying up this summer. It was a 3-year project put together by the California Association of Health Facilities. So that was to fund 300 skilled nursing facilities and provided startup equipment, covered training, and provided startup equipment for at least 15 participants. And they had a study that went along parallel with it the whole time from UC Davis, the Betty Irene Moore School of Nursing. And that study is tying up this summer and should be out, I think, the end of the month. So we'll hope to have some really good, it'll be the largest study for us. Really looking, we don't have it yet, we don't have everything, but we've had some good conversations with the researchers, and it's very positive, so we're looking forward to that one.